Hello everyone, welcome to StudyIQ. In this video, we'll do the current affairs of 16th of March. So let's start the video. Let's start with the quiz as always. And today all the questions I've taken are from the exam. Not even a single question is my own. So these are actual exam questions. Let's see how many will to answer. Which is the World Environment Day 2020 host country? Okay, which is the host country? Which is the first Arab country to obtain membership of Financial Action Task Force? First Middle Eastern country to become a member of FATF. Sukanya is an initiative of which city's police to provide self-defense training to the girl students? Sukanya initiative is by which city's police? Which Indian equestrian officially became the first Indian to qualify for the Tokyo Olympics? First time that an equestrian has qualified for Olympics from India, who is he? Where is the headquarter of Asian Infrastructure Investment Bank? 124th Constitutional Amendment Bill took the form of which number amendment act? So basically, when a bill is passed by both the houses and then signed by the President of India, it becomes an act. So the amendment bill was 124th, but what was the corresponding number of the amendment act? What is the name of the first cyber crime prevention unit of India? And it was launched in which state? That also you can tell me. World Consumer Rights Day is observed on which date every year? India's first national film museum, it was set up in which city? Which animal is present on RBI insignia? You must have seen the insignia of the Reserve Bank of India. Which animal you will find there? Operation Save Karma. Operation Save Karma is related to which animal? It is for the conservation of animal, very specific animal. Which one is it? India's first ever conservation reserve for black buck. It will come up in which state of India? Black buck, of course, is the state animal of Andhra Pradesh and also Haryana and Punjab. Dilwara temple is located in which city? Very important temple, Dilwara temple. Who was the director of the movie Chappak? This movie brought to light the plight of the acid attack victims. And the lead protagonist is a female played by Deepika Padukone. But who was the director? Kundankulam nuclear power plant was made with the help of which country? This nuclear power plant is in Tamil Nadu, but which country helped us to establish this plant? Uttaran scheme is a government scheme of which Indian state? Uttaran scheme. More than 10,000 wild camels, they were shot dead recently in an aerial operation in which country? Because these camels were drinking too much water, and because of the water scarcity, they were shot down. Who was selected for the 2019-2020 Pen Gauri Lankesh Award? Pen Gauri Lankesh Award, named after Gauri Lankesh, the celebrated journalist. The tomb of Sher Shah Suri is located in which town of Bihar? Sher Shah Suri. What is the number of the Lok Sabha seats that you will find in UP, Uttar Pradesh? Lok Sabha seats. And UP has the maximum Lok Sabha seats in India. Therefore, it's very difficult to become Prime Minister of India if you don't do well in UP. So these are the questions. Now let me tell you the answers quickly. World Environment Day, this time 2020, the host country will be Colombia. Colombia is a beautiful South American country, and the capital of Colombia is Bogota. The first Arab country to obtain membership of FATF is actually Saudi Arabia. Saudi Arabia has become a member of FATF. And by the way, Saudi Arabia will host the G20 summit also. The capital of Saudi Arabia is Riyadh. And FATF headquarters is in Paris. Sukanya initiative is by the Kolkata police. Kolkata police, and the purpose of this is basically to provide self-defense training, and especially to the high school girls, Colombia currency also, you can remember, it is Colombian peso. Peso is the currency of Colombia. Indian equestrian is Fawad Mirza. We have only one international standard equestrian, Fawad Mirza. He has qualified for the Olympics. He will be competing with various countries. Headquarter of AIIB you will find in Beijing. And recently, this bank, Asian Infrastructure Investment Bank, it has provided Andhra Pradesh $3 billion worth of loan for their various activities. 124th Constitutional Amendment Bill was actually passed, and it took the form of 103rd Constitutional Amendment Act. And what was it about? It was to give 10% reservation to the economically weaker section. The name of the first cybercrime police unit in India is Ashwast, and it was launched in Gujarat. World Consumer Right Day was observed on 15th of March. But don't get confused. There is something known as National Consumer Rights Day, and National Consumer Right Day is observed on 24th of December. So World Consumer Right Day is 15th of March and National Consumer Right Day is 24th of December. India's first National Film Museum was set up in Mumbai. Here you must remember that Mumbai was also declared as the creative city for films, and Hyderabad was declared as the creative city for cooking. There were only two cities which were selected by UNESCO. The animal that is present in RBI insignia is the Royal Bengal Tiger. Just take a look at the RBI insignia, you will find Royal Bengal Tiger. Operation Save Karma is related to turtle. And one turtle that is very specific to India is the olive ridley turtle, found mainly in Odisha. India's first ever conservation reserve for black buck is coming up in Allahabad, now Prayagraj, so Prayagraj is a better word. Dilwara temple is located in Mount Abu. Mount Abu is in Rajasthan. It is the only hill station in the desert state of Rajasthan. And by the way, in Mount Abu, you will find the highest peak of the Aravallis, which is called Guru Shikhar. So Guru Shikhar peak you will find in Mount Abu, Rajasthan. Chapak movie was directed by Meghna Gulzar. Kundankulam nuclear power plant was made with the help of Russia. It was Russia which helped us to make this. Uttaran scheme is a government scheme related to Assam. Now they are building various sports stadium also under the Uttaran scheme. 10,000 wild camels were shot down in Australia. And 2019-20 Pen Gauri Lankesh Award, who was selected for it? Yusuf Jamil. For this year it was Yusuf Jamil. And he's a journalist from Kashmir. And last year it was Ravish Kumar. Shasuri tomb you will find in Sasaram in Bihar. Sasaram. Lok Sabha seats in UP, how many? 80. 80 Lok Sabha seats. Now let's start the current affairs of 16th of March. International Day of Action for Rivers 2020 was observed on which date? It was observed on 14th of March. International Day of Action for Rivers. And this year, it was the 22nd edition of this International Day of Action for River. 22nd edition. And what was the theme? The theme was Women, Water and Climate Change. This is to basically acknowledge the role of women in preventing the climate change. And also remember, there are two rivers that were also in news recently. So one is the Mandovi River. Mandovi River is basically in Goa and Karnataka, and it is also called Mahadai River. There is a Mandovi or Mahadai River dispute also between Goa, Karnataka and Maharashtra. And this river was in news because India's first floating jetty has been started here. India's first floating jetty was started on Mandovi River. And another river that was in news is the Mithi River, MITHI, which is in Mumbai. And recently, a cleaning drive for Mithi River was started in Maharashtra. The government has approved a proposal for the construction of 780 kilometers of green highways in 4 states. Which state will not be covered under it? Green highways will be constructed. It was announced recently. There will be 780 kilometers of road building. Green highway project will cost 760 crore rupees. It was announced by Prakash Javadekar, the Minister for Environment. And the states that are covered are Himachal Pradesh, Rajasthan, Uttar Pradesh and Andhra Pradesh. So Madhya Pradesh is not a part of it, rather we have Andhra Pradesh. Dana Zatopkova passed away recently. She was associated with which sport? She was associated with javelin throw. She was a javelin champion in the 1952 Olympics. She was the javelin champion. And by the way, she was the wife of 4 times Olympic champion, Mr. Emil Zatopek. Emil Zatopek. And she was from Czech Republic. She was from Czech Republic. And 1952 Olympics were in Helsinki, capital of Finland. And it was in this Olympic that KD Jadhav got India the first ever individual medal. It was a bronze medal in wrestling. Who has been named as Google's most searched for woman in music for 2020? Most searched woman in the field of music is Taylor Swift. Taylor Swift. What about in the author? Who is the woman in the space of literature who was most searched? Toni Morrison. So Toni Morrison was the most searched woman author in 2000 and in this edition of 2020. What about sports person? Serena Williams. Serena Williams was the most searched female sports person in this 2020 list by Google. India's first living culinary arts museum has been founded by which person? It has been founded, first culinary arts museum. And it has been founded by Chef Vikas Khanna. He is a Michelin rated chef. And this museum has been opened in Vagsha, which is in Manipal, Udupi district of Karnataka. It is called Welcome Group Institute. So it is basically a hotel management institute by Welcome Group. It is called Vagsha, Manipal, Udupi. Which state government has ordered poultry culling to control bird flu? Which state government is it that has ordered poultry culling? Culling means what? You kill the hens, you kill the chickens, so that the bird flu, which is also called avian influenza. So remember, avian influenza is called bird flu. It is the government of Kerala. And recently bird flu is spreading in Kerala and Karnataka, also in some parts of Andhra and Tamil Nadu as well. Remember, India today is the fifth largest producer of eggs in the world. Ganga Amantran Abhiyan, which is an open water rafting expedition. So not only rafting, but you will also have kayaking sport in this expedition. It is conducted between which two places? So it is conducted between Dev Prayag and Ganga Sagar. Ganga Sagar is the final place where Ganga enters the Bay of Bengal, and Ganga Sagar is basically in Sundarban. A part of Ganga, it drains into the Bay of Bengal, and the other one enters Bangladesh. In Bangladesh, what is the name of Ganga River? It is called Padma. And by the way, at Dev Prayag is where River Ganga is formed by the confluence of two rivers. One is called Bhagirathi and the Alaknanda. Bhagirathi and Alaknanda, they both join together to make Ganga River at Dev Prayag in Uttarakhand. And Ganga Mantran Abhiyan was launched by the Ministry for Jal Shakti, and Gajendra Singh Shekhawat is the Minister for Jal Shakti. In the 39th GST Council meeting, the goods and services tax of the mobile phones, it has been increased now from 12% to what? So GST on mobile phone has been increased from 12% to 18%. 12% to 18%. The Union Cabinet approved to withdraw the MEIS, Merchandise Export from India scheme, in phases to be replaced by which scheme? So remember, MEIS will be replaced by RODTEP, RODTEP, which means remission of duties or taxes on export products. This scheme is for the exporters to reimburse taxes and duties paid by them, like electricity duty or value added tax, etc. And this is for that tax which is not getting exempted or refunded under any other mechanism. So MEIS will be replaced by RODTEP. And another thing, remember, this RODTEP, it is in compliance with the WTO rules, World Trade Organization norms. Which country has sought financial help from International Monetary Fund first time since 1962 to fight against COVID-19? This country is Iran. Iran is asking the help from IMF for the first time. In Iran, the morbidity and mortality because of coronavirus is huge. After China and Italy, probably Iran is the third most affected country. And IMF is headed by Kristalina Georgieva. She is from Bulgaria. Who has been appointed as the brand ambassador of Realme? Realme is a mobile phone company. Its brand ambassador now is Shraddha Kapoor and Salman Khan, both. So Salman Khan was made the brand ambassador 3 weeks back, and now Shraddha Kapoor has also been made the brand ambassador for Realme. And another mobile company called IQ, its brand ambassador is Virat Kohli. Eka Tarini Sakela Rao Palau has been sworn in as the first female president of which country? It was announced earlier, but finally she has been sworn in as the first female president of Greece, the all-important country Greece. Greece's capital is Athens and currency is Euro. By the way, talking of Athens, the first ever Olympic Games took place in Greece. And a very similar name, there is a mountain also in Greece which is very popular and frequented by tourists across the globe. This mountain in Greece is called Mount Olympus. And Mount Olympus is the highest mountain of Greece. By the way, in Greece, since I'm talking about Olympics, remember the Olympic Games will take place in Tokyo in 2020 if they are not postponed, but location will remain the same. And Anna Korakaki, she is a gold medalist in Olympics from Greece. Anna Korakaki, she was given the honor to be the first torch bearer for the Tokyo Olympics. India has handed over 600 ton of rice to which flood-hit country? This country is Madagascar, located on the rim of the Indian Ocean, and Madagascar's capital is Antananarivo. India is giving a help of 600 ton of rice. Which state has launched the Kaushal Satrang Yuva Hub and Apprenticeship Schemes? Which state? All of these have been launched by the Uttar Pradesh government. What is this Kaushal Satrang? Kaushal Satrang, you know, will have various components that will provide opportunities to the youth. And the UP government has partnered with IIT Kanpur to launch Kaushal Satrang scheme. They will basically make sure that 2 lakh youth are employed under Kaushal Satrang. What is Yuva Hub? Yuva Hub is basically, you know, it is also aimed at providing the skilled youth assistance in placements. And they have partnered with IIM Lucknow for the same. And the third one is the apprenticeship scheme, which is very easy to understand. Basically, the youth will be given an apprenticeship or internship or training for 6 months, and they will also be given a sum of 2500 rupees per month. A newly identified species of tree hopper has been named after which person? It has been named after Lady Gaga. Lady Gaga, who is a renowned singer. And by the way, this species has been discovered in a country called Nicaragua. And it has been now named as Kaikia, K-A-I-K-A-I-A Gaga. Before this, if you remember, there was a snail species which was named after Greta Thunberg also. Under which act the central government has authorized the state government to take preventive measures against the coronavirus? This act is the 1897 Epidemic Disease Act. Epidemic Disease Act of 1897. Who has been dropped from the commentary panel of the BCCI, Board of Control for Cricket in India, BCCI? Its president is Saurav Ganguly and secretary is Jay Shah. So remember, Sanjay Manjrekar will not be doing the commentary now. World Consumer Rights Day is celebrated on which date? World Consumer Rights Day is on 15th of March. And when is the National Consumer Rights Day? 24th of December. What was the theme for the World Consumer Rights Day this year? It is the sustainable consumer. Very easy to remember. The sustainable consumer. Recently, Indian mountaineer Amgoth Tukaram, he climbed the highest peak of Australia called Mount Kosciuszko. He is from which state? Amgoth Tukaram, he is from Telangana. Another mountaineer from Telangana was in news recently. And who is she? Malavath Purna. Malavath Purna became the youngest to climb certain peaks. She is from Telangana. And one more, Bhavna Deharia. Now, can you write down in comments why Bhavna Deharia was in news recently? Name the Indian who has been named in the list of 10 most influential women in sports for 2020. This list has been released by Sports Business Network iSport Connect. It is Neeta Ambani. Neeta Ambani is in the list of 10 most influential women in sports. And can you tell me that Neeta Ambani owns which IPL cricket team? So that was the video for 16th of March. God bless you and take care.